Okay, so what's going on, guys? So the PS4 Pro just came out yesterday, and I want to go ahead and talk about it with you guys because there's been so much controversy from it not running games well, from it not being actual native 4K, a lot of the games, and this is so much stuff going on. I want to go ahead and talk about it with you guys. So without further ado, let's go ahead and hop right into this. Now, first, I want to start off with games not running in native 4K. Now, there are only two games that I know of, to my knowledge, 100% that run in full native 4K resolution. And that is The Last of Us Remastered, and what else am I missing? Skyrim, The Elder Scrolls V, Special Edition. So, now, this is something that I think we all should have expected for a while. Like, we shouldn't have expected every single game out the gate to run at 4K. Because keep in mind, at this current moment, these consoles, in a lot of cases, can't even do 1080p 60fps. Now, in some cases, this may be the developer's fault why, you know, these games can't do that kind of... Well, it may be the developer's fault why they can't pull off this kind of performance, but at the same time, it is also a lot to do with the console, okay? We're still running with some hardware that is relatively old, and it's struggling to keep up with, you know, a lot of the games that are being ran nowadays. For example, Fallout 4. Now, while that may not be the PS4's fault, it's more of the old engine. It's still, in a lot of cases, kind of, you know, it's kind of being limited. Because you take, for example, a PC. You could take a graphics card like the GTX 970, slap it in there, and run Fallout 4, and you'll get respective frames. Even though it is an old game on an old engine, the GTX 970 can still run the game relatively well. And with, like I said, with these consoles, a lot of them have pretty old hardware, and they're really limited in a lot of ways. And I just wasn't expecting a full native 4K resolution. I mean, you, like I said, look at other games that come out now. We have the Batman Arkham, what's it called? Batman Return to Arkham, which have super old games. Batman Arkham City came out in 2011, and Batman Arkham Asylum came out in 2009, I believe. And for whatever reason, these games don't even run at a full 1920 by 1080 resolution. They run, I think it's like 1600 by 900, I believe. It's not even full 1080p with a really stuttering 30fps. I mean, it's just really bad. I would say in a lot of cases, that may not even be the console's fault. Again, that could just be the developers. But at the same time, I feel like there are also other games out there that are just struggling by the console as opposed to what developers can actually do. I mean, we'll take, for example, we'll look at a game like MGS5, okay? It runs at 1080p, 60fps, and it's an open world game, okay? And it runs 60fps on the Xbox One. Well, I'm sorry. Yeah, it runs at 720p 60 on the Xbox One, 1080p 60 on the PS4, and whatever frame rate on the PC. So, I just really wasn't expecting too much from this, okay? Like I said, in some cases, these consoles, they really just can't handle too much. I mean, you could take games like Deus Ex, Mankind Divided, like I said, Fallout 4. There's a couple of other games where it just really cannot handle. And again, this may be the fault of the developers, but I do think at some point, the PS4 is just really limited. It's really limited. And I'm not just talking about on what you can do. I'm talking about the actual console itself in terms of raw performance. And the fact that they're keep marketing this 4K, I didn't buy it, okay? I just really did not buy it. This is just something that really seems to be like it's more of a gimmick, okay? Like, and the thing is that it's not even full native 4K, it's upscale 4K that's using some kind of weird checkerboard rendering, which I don't know, it's really weird, but it's upscale 4K, which means that it's not actual true native 4K. I keep saying, take a shot every time I say 4K, but yeah, it's just not native 4K, and that was something that I knew from Jump Street. Like, I was always wondering, how are they going to pull this off? Like, a lot of these games don't even run at 1080p 60 frames per second. So how on earth could they possibly manage 4K? A lot of them can't even pull off 1080p for whatever reason. And then, I mean, you also have the thing where, like I said, these consoles are really old, okay? They're pretty old. I'm not saying they're dying old, but they're getting up there in the years in terms of the hardware that they're using. So I just feel like that's just something that they cannot achieve just yet. And I feel like what should have been more paid attention more was actual like 60 frames per second. Let's get that in all our games, okay? Let's give me Fallout 4 at 60 FPS on my PS4. I mean, that'd be awesome. And not to mention the fact that not many people have a 4K television. I mean, myself, you know, I'm gonna buy a 4K television. Black Friday is right around the corner. I believe it is exactly 14 days as I'm making this video, and I'm gonna buy a 4K TV. I already have it planned out. Gonna buy a 55-inch Philips 4K television. It's Black Friday sale at my job. I'm gonna get it. Why not? And I mean, even then, I have a 4K television. I'm not that interested in 4K gaming yet because I feel like it's not exactly there. It's not that affordable. Like, the sweet spot now is 1080p 60 frames per second, and that is what most people play at least 1080p. Most people have a 1080p either TV or monitor that they play their games on. So I'm not really there yet at 4K. Hell, I'm not even at 1440p yet because all of this stuff is so expensive. If I wanted to get a good enough 4K experience, I'd have to buy a 4K television, which I'm gonna get, and a graphics card that can actually handle that kind of power, which that would be a GTX 1070 or a 1080 or a Titan X Pascal or the 1080 Ti whenever that comes out. So there, 4K gaming for me is just not there. I mean, it's there, it's doable, it's playable, but in terms of cost and what I'd be spending compared to 1080p, it's really just not there yet, if you follow what I'm saying. Like, it's just not at that point where I can make that leap, I can make that jump to where I can say, you know what, screw 1080p, I'm going straight for 4K, that's what I'm gonna do everything on. I mean, lots of movies today are not at 4K, it's just so many things that just are not there for 4K. I mean, like I said, it is there, okay, but it's not there to where you can completely remove 1080p and make it obsolete. That's what I'm saying, it's just not at that full force that I know it could be at. Like, you remember when 1080p completely took over? 4K is, that's not what 4K is yet. It's on the up and coming. It's, you know, it's getting there, but it's just not there yet. And I mean, not to mention some of the price for like the actual, you know, really, really good 4K televisions. I mean, you got some that I've seen that are $4,000, $2,000. I'm not saying that's the kind of TV you need for a PS4, you know, a PS4 Pro or just a proper 4K experience. But I'm talking about the best of the best are just so expensive. I mean, you take my, take my Asus monitor I have right here. It is a Asus, I can't remember the exact numbers, but it's a 144Hz monitor, 1 millisecond response time, and it was $264 when I got this thing, okay? And this, I would say, is a sweet spot, okay? This was very affordable. So, and this is one of the best, you know, 1080p monitors you can get for PC gaming. And then you look at some of the best 4K televisions with HDR, they are like $4,000, $2,000. Sometimes even $1,500. With that money, you can do so much more. And at the end of the day, all you're getting is just prettier graphics. I'm more of a guy who prefers raw gameplay. Well, not raw. Well, let me clarify what I just said. I'm someone who prefers smooth gameplay, okay? I'm talking about buttery smooth gameplay as opposed to pretty graphics. Tone everything down and give me a solid performing game. That's what I want. That's what I'm focused on. From a marketing standpoint, I can see why they went with the 4K thing because, you know, it is coming. It is going to be here soon. May not be tomorrow, may not be next year, the year after next, but it will be here soon, okay? But it just, I just feel like it's not there. Okay, for a lot of people, it's really not there. I can see why they went with it, but it's not there. 4K is not at that point for a lot of people where they can just make that jump and completely say, all right, look, 1080p TV, it's obsolete. Don't need it anymore. You throw it away. 4K is what's happening. It's not there yet. That's what I'm saying. It's just, it's not at that point. And I just really don't see, like, I can see why a lot of people don't even feel the need to buy it because, I mean, there really aren't no substantial upgrades, really. And let's go ahead and talk about the games, okay? The games and the performance. There's been so much talk, mainly Digital Foundry. They've been analyzing, testing the games, the frame rate and all that, and they found that a lot of games are running worse on the Pro as opposed to the actual regular PS4. You have games like Skyrim, The Elder Scrolls V, you have The Last of Us, and I think Deus Ex, Mankind Divided also. These are games running worse on the newer hardware as opposed to the old hardware, which really leaves you scratching your head to say, okay, why did I spend this money if I'm getting worse performance? I mean, I got this because it was advertised as a 4K player or a 4K, a console that can play games at 4K and a console that can run games in 1080p better than the original, okay? So I'm stuck scratching my head like, okay, what was the point of this? I mean, it's running worse. Now, me personally, I believe the reason why it's running as bad as it is right now is because the developers are still learning how to utilize the technology. They're still learning how to make everything work. They're not at that point yet where they can just easily put things together, if you follow what I'm saying. Well, take, for example, a game like Uncharted 4, which was designed from the ground up on the PS4, released, no problems, okay? The PS4 Pro just came out. This is new technology to a lot of developers. A lot of developers are just getting dev kits, and they're still learning how to master this technology and still learn how to work everything out. And you got games like The Last of Us Remastered, which is a game that came out in 2013, still not running that well compared to the older hardware. So that leads me to believe that the developers really are just still trying to learn everything. They're learning the hardware. You could take a game like Mass Effect Andromeda, which is pretty much going to be designed from the ground up on both PS4 and PS4 Pro. That will, I think, will run a whole lot better than the developers will have a clear understanding of the technology that they're using, and since it's being designed from the ground up with PS4 Pro in mind, I do believe that this will be a lot better than a lot of the games we're seeing now. Like I just said, The Last of Us Remastered, Skyrim, Deus Ex, Mankind Divided, I'm pretty sure it will perform much better than those games because the developers will have more time, they've had more time, to sit there and try to learn this new technology and get it in their hands so that it can just, it can be perfected, so that when the newer games come out, you know, it'll just, things will just be a lot smoother. I think right now, developers are just, you know, they're ironing out the wrinkles, okay? They're trying to get everything in order, they're trying to learn this technology so that, you know, later on down the line, when they have to actually make games with the PS4 Pro in mind, everything will be smooth sailing. That's what I personally believe, okay? Because I feel like there's no reason why a new console with much better hardware than the previous console is doing worse. It just doesn't make any sense to me. So I think that's what's going on. Developers are just still trying to learn everything with this new console. They're trying to find a way to tap into that raw power and make the experience as good as it could possibly be. So that's what I think, because right now the PS4 Pro isn't really doing too well by a lot of people's standards. A lot of people are pissed off about it. A lot of people just aren't really satisfied with their experience. And frame rate, you know, a whole bunch of other things. Frame rate is a really big thing. It's a very key thing in gaming. And for the PS4 Pro, it's really struggling in some areas. And like I said, I think it's because devs are still learning the hardware. They're learning the software. They're learning how to do everything. And I'm telling you, I really think by the end of next year, not saying that this is how long it's going to take, but I'm just using this as an example. By the end of next year, when we have like the Xbox Scorpio, we have Red Dead Redemption 2, I'm pretty sure we're going to see a smooth gaming experience on the Pro. Mark my words on that. Right now, they're just learning what they're doing, and before you know it, things will be good to go. So, yeah, pretty much the controversy behind the PS4 Pro is that a lot of people just aren't satisfied with the whole 4K thing. And the 4K Blu-ray player, let's touch on that real quick. So they decided we're not going to put a 4K Blu-ray player in our console because this is mainly geared towards gaming. How do you drop the ball like that? Because the biggest thing about the PS3 was that it had a Blu-ray player in it. Okay, that was one of the big things about the PS3. And you just take that away and now, like, it's like, what? How? Like, that was so revolutionary for the PS3. Believe it or not, okay? The PS3 had that. No, Netflix was mostly viewed on PlayStation 3s way back when. I think it probably is even now, okay? And, I mean, it's like, how do you go wrong with that? It's like, how do you go wrong with something like that? I mean, Blu-ray and a 4K Blu-ray player, the Xbox One S has one, okay? And that's I mean, it's still building off, you know, hardware that came out in 2013, but yet you, or what's 2013? I think it was 2013, and yet you guys don't have a 4K Blu-ray player. Like, you're a 4K gaming console, yet you don't have 4K Blu-ray. Why not? It's like, I don't even understand that logic. And it's like, a lot of people are saying, I'm not gonna buy it because it's like, it doesn't have a 4K Blu-ray player. If I'm gonna invest in 4K, I might as well go all the way with gaming and movies. I mean, why not? It makes sense, doesn't it? So yeah, man, I would say they really dropped the ball on that one, because I feel like if you were really looking to invest in 4K, you might as well go all the way. Don't just stop at gaming, go with movies. And if you're, you know, if you like watching movies, don't stop at movies, go with games if you're a gamer. So I just really don't get the point. What was the point of not including 4K in your console? I mean, that's, like I said, it's one of the most, that was one of the most biggest things about Sony back with the PS3, was it had a Blu-ray player. Now the PS4 Pro doesn't have a 4K Blu-ray player. Like, what was the point of that? Like, that honestly turned me away from it, you know, aside from other things. As to why I didn't get it is because I'm gonna be getting a 4K TV. I'm gonna want to watch 4K movies. So now I have to get an Xbox One S. Now you could say you could just buy a 4K Blu-ray player. I don't think I really wanted. I mean, I might as well just get an Xbox One that was gonna be it's gonna end up being cheaper. You know what I'm saying? It just doesn't make any sense. So I gotta get an Xbox One S if I actually want to watch movies in 4K. And I'll use my PC for 4K gaming if I ever get to that point where I want to play games in 4K. I don't really see the point in getting a console for that when the better true native 4K experience is on PC. Now, I don't want to sound like I'm some PC master race type of person. I'm just saying that's what I would do, because these consoles right now, they're, like I said, they're still in the learning process. They're still ironing out all the wrinkles and making sure everything is good, and they're learning the technology, which is going to take some time. So, like, yeah, man, it's just, I don't really see the point in what they're doing with 4K right now. Like, I mean, yeah, it is up and coming in the future, but right now, the PS4 Pro, it still has some things that need to be ironed out. So let me tell you this, if you're looking to buy a PS4 Pro and you want it for 4K, that's cool. There's nothing wrong with that. But what I do think you should do is wait on it just a little bit longer. Wait till the developers actually know what they're doing and they actually have everything patched out and everything is ready to go. Because believe me, I would not mind playing The Last of Us in 4K. Okay, I played the game 3 times already. I loved The Last of Us. All right, and to see it in 4K, wow, that sounds beautiful. Okay, that sounds amazing. And I think that just sounds amazing. Okay, don't even get me started on that. And I just feel like down the road, it'll be a lot better. Like I said, The Last of Us 4K, that just sounds beautiful. Okay, that sounds beautiful. So I think we just need to go ahead and wait, and everything will be good to go. Like I said, some of the controversies behind this whole console is the fact that it doesn't have a 4K Blu-ray player. A lot of the games are running like shit on 4K, and there aren't that many games supported. And you have to pretty much wait for devs to actually, bring over patches for the PS4 Pro. So my suggestion to you is, if you own a 4K TV with HDR, to just wait just a little bit longer for 4K on the PS4 Pro. Give it some time, and then I would say give it till maybe next year. All right, maybe even a couple of weeks when a lot of these games are actually patched properly. And then you go in for the kill, get you a 4K PS4 Pro, and you'll be good to go. Or you can just wait for the Xbox Scorpio, which everybody's talking about to be this amazing console. You know, I'm not even going to hop on that bandwagon until I actually see some raw performance of this thing, because that's how I was with the PS4 Pro. I was not insane about it. I was looking forward to it, but I was not insane about it, because nowadays in gaming, it's so easy to be let down. I mean, we have so many games that just give off a good example of that. So I'm not gonna get my hopes up on anything just yet. I'm gonna wait and see what the Scorpio looks like. I might even get one, because I can tell you right now, the Scorpio sounds cool for the simple fact that it's a more powerful console. It's gonna actually offer true native 4K gaming as a 4K Blu-ray player. You can actually play games in backwards compatibility, and not to mention the fact that it has mods. Now, I don't have to really worry about mods, because, well, that's if a lot of the Xbox One, well, I'm pretty sure it will. But again, I'm not really too fixated on like mods and things like that, because I can just do that crap on PC. But I'm just saying it has a lot of features going for it, and, you know, the performance of this just sounds so much more interesting. And like I said, native 4K, 4K Blu-ray player. I mean, and it's just a much more powerful console, and it just sounds really cool. And I might even get Red Dead Redemption on it, not to mention backwards compatibility. So, I can just play Red Dead Redemption 1 and go right to 2 on the Xbox Scorpio in 4K, if that's actually going to be, you know, if that's actually going to be a thing, because you never know. This console could come out and it could just completely flop, okay? It could completely flop, but we're going to have to wait and see on that. This video is not about the Xbox Scorpio, so we're just going to go back to the PS4 Pro. Like I said before, I would wait on it if I were you. Just give it to, like, maybe next year or maybe even next month. pick up a PS4 Pro and just, I think it's gonna work out, guys. I really think it's gonna work out. If you have a PS4 Pro now watching this video, you're probably saying, man, I wasted all this money on it. It's not as good as I thought it was gonna be. Don't feel that way. Just give it some time. Give it some time. And I'm pretty sure the PS4 Pro is going to knock the ball out the park. It's gonna be awesome. Just give it time and things will work out. Things will definitely work out. I mean, we've seen it before with the Xbox 360 and the PS3. A lot of games didn't exactly run that well coming out the gate. But as time went on, things actually got better. So just give it some time, and I think things will just work. So that's it for this video. I rambled on a lot longer than I expected. To sum everything up, though, pretty much the controversy behind the PS4 Pro is the last time I'm going to say this, because I'm pretty sure I've said this before. I have a bad habit of repeating myself sometimes. But PS4 Pro does not have a 4K Blu-ray player, PS4 Pro doesn't have that many games compatible, and PS4 Pro runs games like absolute shit compared to the regular PS4. If I'm forgetting anything, which I probably am, be sure to let me know in the comment section below, and we could talk about it there. So, thanks so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please be sure to give it a rating. It really helps the channel grow, and I will catch you guys later. So, thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, have a great day.